Hello friends, welcome to TechStudySell. In this video, we'll make a very useful IoT project using ESP Rainmaker to control 8 appliances with Google Assistant, Alexa, and also from the manual switches. And you can monitor the real-time feedback, and if there is no internet, still you can control the appliances from the manual switches. For this project, you don't need any eco device, and I have used all the free tools, so everything is free. And during the video, I have shared the complete circuit source code so that you can easily make this project. Although you can make this circuit just by using a ESP32 and a relay module, but it is better to use a PCB for this project to avoid any loose connection. And you can easily design professional PCBs for your any electronics project using the Altium PCB designing software. Altium is a very well-known and most trusted PCB designing software. The user interface is so simple that you can easily design any complex PCB in Altium. And it also provides a lot of useful tools and features for routing, which will save you a lot of time, and you will find a lot of details tutorial which will help you to use this software to make professional PCB very easily. So I will highly recommend you to download the free trial version of the Altium software from video description, and later on if you like this software you can purchase it. Now before going to the details, let me show you how this project works.
Hey Google,
turn on switch 4. You can see the lamp turns on. Now let me use Alexa to turn it off. Alexa, turn off switch 4.
Okay.
You can give any name to these devices. Now if I go to device, I can also control these lamps with the Amazon Alexa app. Let me turn on all the lamps. So you can see all the lamp turns on. Now let me use Google to turn off all the lamps.
Hey Google,
turn off all the switch.
Okay, turning 8 switches off.
And you can also use the Google Home app. Let me open the Google Home app, and I can also control the lamps with this Google Home app. So let me turn on some lamps from this Google Home app. And you can see I can easily control it. Now let me go to the Amazon Alexa app. As I said, I can monitor the real-time feedback. So let me go to the switch 8. Currently the lamp turns off. If I turn it on from the manual switch, and you can monitor the real-time feedback in the Amazon Alexa app. Let me turn it off, and the status updated. And apart from that, as I said, I can also control it from the manual switches. Now let me turn off the Wi-Fi to show you how it works without internet. Currently the blue LED is glowing, which indicates ESP32 is connected to the Wi-Fi. Let me turn it off. After turning off the Wi-Fi, you can see the blue LED turns off, and here it is showing no internet connection in the Amazon Alexa app. So I can control the appliances only from the manual switches. And as you can see, I can easily control the lamps with the switches. Now let me turn on the Wi-Fi again. So now it is connected with the Wi-Fi. So let me control it with Alexa again. So if I tap here, the second lamp turns off. Apart from that, I can also control the appliances from the ESP Rainmaker dashboard. So here you can see these are the switches. So I can easily control the lamps from this dashboard. And if I tap here, you can see I can also add member to this dashboard. So if you want to control the appliances from different smartphone, you just have to enter the mail ID and tap on add. So this is a very useful features, and after watching this video, any beginner can make this project. This is very simple and very useful IoT project. So without any further delay, let's get started. To make this project, you need a ESP32. You can use either 4 channel or 8 channel relay module. And to control the relays manually, you can use either latch switch or push button. Now you have to connect all these components as per this circuit diagram. In the circuit, I have given the 5 volt supply to ESP32 and a relay module. And these switches are connected across the GPIO pins and the ground pin.
Now if you want to use push button, then you can refer this circuit. And please take proper safety precaution while connecting this AC appliances with the relay module. Now if you want to use 4 channel relay module, then you can refer this circuit for switches, and this is the circuit for the push button. As you can see, the circuits are very simple. You can easily make it without using any PCB.
But as I said, you can also design professional PCBs for your any project using the Altium PCB designing software. You can find the download link in the description.
And for this project, you can also use these PCBs. I have shared the GABA file in the video description. Now let's move to the coding part of this project. These are the source codes for this project. You can download all these codes from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the article link given in the description, then you can download all the codes from these buttons. Now as you can see, I have shared the 4 source code. So you can use these codes for the 4 channel relay module, and these 2 codes are for the 8 channel relay module. Now let me open the code for the 8 channel relay module with switches. Now before programming the ESP32, we have to follow some steps. First, in the preference, we have to update these 2 URL. So let me copy it. Now I will go to file, then select preference. Then here you have to paste the URLs. Now click on OK. After that, I will go to tools. Then I will select board and go to board manager. Then here I have to search for ESP32. From here, you have to install the 2.0.3 version of ESP32 board. So you have to click on install or update the ESP32 board to this version. This is very important. After that, you have to define the names for the device. So for the first device, I have given the name switch 1. You can give any name like room light, study lamp, according to your requirement. As you are going to control 8 channel relay module, so here I have provided 8 name like switch 1, switch 2, switch 8. So if you want, you can change this or you can keep as it is. After that, I have defined all the GPIO pins I have used for this project. Now let me go to the void setup. In the void setup, I have given the node name as ESP32 Relay 8. You can also change this if you want, or you can keep it as it is. So if you refer the same circuit and you don't want to change the name for the device, you can directly upload the same code after downloading. For that, go to tools, then in the board select the ESP32 dev module. Then here in the partition scheme, you have to select the Rainmaker. After that, select the proper port. Now we can hit the upload button. After uploading the code, I will open the serial monitor. Then select the baud rate 115200. Now I will press and hold the boot button for 4 seconds. Then I will release the button. Now here you can see I have to scan this QR code, but it is not clear. So let me copy the link just below the QR code. Then I will paste the link in the browser and open the page. Now with this QR code, we can easily enter the Wi-Fi credential to ESP32 using ESP Rainmaker app. Let me open the app. Now before scanning the QR code, I have to turn on the Bluetooth and location. Now I will tap on add device and scan the QR code. So now I will tap on pair. Now I have to enter the Wi-Fi details. So this is the Wi-Fi name. Let me type the password. Now it will take some time. You can see all the device added to our Rainmaker app if I tap on done. So now you can see all the 8 devices we have created, and this is the node name ESP32 Relay 8. Now I will quickly connect the Google Assistant and Amazon Alexa with this Rainmaker. So I will tap on setting, then I will tap on voice service. First I will tap on Amazon Alexa, and here I will tap on link with Amazon Alexa. So now I will tap on link. Now here I will select continue with Google. You can also enter the ID and password. Let me select the mail ID. Now it is showing already linked with Amazon Alexa. Now let me open the Amazon Alexa app. So if I go to device,
you can see the 8 device already added in the Amazon Alexa app. Now again I will go to the Rainmaker app. So now we will connect the Google Assistant. For that we have to open the Google Home app. So let me open the Google Home app. You can install this app from Google Play Store or App Store. Now I will tap on this plus icon. First I will create a home. So I will tap on create new home, and here let me give the name smart home. You can give any name. Now I will tap on continue. I will not enter any home address, so I will skip this step and select continue without address. So our home is created. Now again I will tap on this plus icon and select setup device, and now I will tap on works with Google. Here I have to search for Rainmaker. So let me type the Rainmaker. So I have to tap on this ESP Rainmaker. Now I will tap on continue. Now let me exit to main dashboard. So here you can see all the 8 devices added successfully. And during this process, you can see the blue LED is glowing, which indicate now the ESP32 is connected with the Wi-Fi. Now let me connect the ESP32 with the relay module according to the circuit. As you can see, I have made the complete circuit. Now let me try to control the appliances from the Rainmaker app. So this is a very useful IoT project. If you like it, then please give a thumbs up and share it with your friends. And I will really appreciate if you support our work on Patreon. It will motivate us to make more such videos. If you find this project helpful, then please give a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.